Welcome. I'm Brad McCann, your colony advisor. I will introduce you to the basic operations and goals for building a new moon colony. I'm here to help, so whenever you want to go on to the next step, just click on my picture and we'll be on our way. Go ahead and click on me now. First, you need to think three-dimensionally, because all operations are performed in 3D. To have a quick look around, hold the right mouse button down while you move the mouse around. When you're done trying it out, click on my picture and we'll move right along. If you have a wheel mouse, you can zoom in and out by rolling the wheel. If you don't have a wheel mouse, it's okay. You can still zoom in and out by using the keyboard. Use the Help or Options menus for a list of controls, and click on my picture when you're done. Good. Now move the cursor to the sides and corners of your monitor. The screen will automatically scroll to help you move around quickly. You can also use the camera orbit buttons in the bottom right section of your screen. Try the button in the center of the camera orbit. That's your satellite view. So far, so good. Click on my picture when you're done. Probably want to adjust the speed at which the camera moves around, depending upon the processing power of your computer. You can use the Help or Options menus to adjust your settings and customize your controls. Click on me when you're done. Okay, let's get started. First thing your colony needs is a control center. Look around for a spot with level ground and left-click on the Operations button in the control panel to your right. Now click on the Control Center button that pops out of the expanding list. This info window tells you all the building facts. Click on the Build button when you're ready, and you'll see your building contained in a box. The box is red when you move it to a bad place where the ground is not level. Move the box until you find a good spot where it turns green. Now left-click to build, or right-click to cancel the building process. Click me when you're done. Okay, now you can start building the rest of the colony infrastructure. In order to work, all of the buildings in the colony either need to touch one another or be joined via connection tubes. Let's go ahead and make some connection tubes now. Press Rotate repeatedly to cycle through the different kinds of connection tubes, and click the left mouse button to lay down a few. When you're done, we'll build some living space for your first colonists. As I mentioned before, you can use the Help or Options menus to adjust your settings and customize your controls to help you rotate. Very good. Now let's make some homes. Left-click on the Operations button, expand the Personnel section, and choose Inflatable Shelter. Up pops the info window so you can find out what this building requires to run properly and produces to benefit your colony. The description tells you whatever else you need to know. Go ahead and click the Build button when you're ready, and left-click to place this building on the lunar terrain so it's connected to the control center, either through your tubes or actually touching the control center. It takes a little time for your colonists to construct a building. You can zoom in and left-click on the building to bring up a status window showing the percentage completion of your new building. Or you can speed things up by accelerating the game speed on the control panel below. When your habitats are finished being constructed, click on me and we'll move along. Well done. Now your colony needs power. Left-click the Utilities button and expand the menu for Electricity. Choose Solar Power and place a few on the map so they are connected to your colony. When your solar power panels are finished being constructed, click on me and we'll move along. All right then. Your colony also needs oxygen and water. So build a water plant and an oxygen plant from the utilities button menus. Remember, you can always rotate a building by pressing the rotate key before you set it in place. The oxygen plant is a big building, so you may need to rotate it to get it to fit nicely. Use the help or options menus for a list of controls. Click on my picture when you're done. Special type of connection tube used to connect buildings at different terrain heights. To use the underground tube, place one next to a building in your colony and place a second one in the new area you want to build. Now you can make new buildings connected to the second underground tube. The maximum range between two underground tubes is 5 tiles. If you wish to expand further, simply use additional underground tubes. And not working when it's finished being built, left-click on it to bring up its status window. Check to make sure you have enough resources for the building. Deficiencies will be indicated in red. You may need to build some more habitats so you have enough people to run your new building. When your new buildings are finished being constructed, click on me and we'll move along. Now your colony is equipped with the basic needs. If you want to stay in touch with Earth and trade goods, you must build a communication system. First, build a landing pad, then a beacon tower, and finally a radio tower. You'll find these structures under the communications submenu of the operations bar. Note, you must have a working beacon tower before you will be able to select and build your radio tower. click on them to bring up their status windows. Mining probes have a small scanning radius, so finding a good spot can be challenging. Maybe you need to build a few more to find the one with the highest percentage of raw materials. When you've decided on the best one, build a small mine right on top of the probe. Mining facilities are found under the production submenu of the industry bar. Take care of business in the expenses submenu of the commerce button. Expenses are monthly costs that your colony must pay to keep things running smoothly. You can adjust the amount of money you spend in the expenses submenu of the commerce button. If you lower expenses, you can save some money, but you will risk making your colonists unhappy or even cause colony disasters. Alright then, that's the end of the tutorial. There are many more aspects of the game for you to explore, such as the tourism and research industries. Also, you'll need to pay careful attention to your colonists' morale and the attraction value of your colony. If your colonists are unhappy, your colony will suffer. And if your colony has a low attraction value, no tourists will want to visit. Just remember, try to make your colony the kind of place you would want to live, and you should do fine. So go ahead and expand your colony now with new buildings and find new ways to generate money. If you missed any part of the tutorial, don't worry. Just click on my picture and I'll start again. Good luck and have fun.